When you get to a lot of pirates and then you see the Moody, are you not like, hey, which one is this one? See, I can't like it, man.
Look, man.
You know, before you start, Nick, I didn't believe that existed, eh? No. I thought people were lying, bro.
It exists. It happens. Because the thing is, you join a lot of pirates, you're such an excitement, very young boy from Soweto, but struggled so much, now playing for one of the biggest clubs in the country.
Yeah.
Right? I'm excited, I'm playing for the team. But I got to understand later on that every club has got its own rituals.
Right? Yes.
Every club does things in its own ways.
Yeah, their own culture.
Yeah. And with what happened, what was happening at Atlanta Pirates at the time, it wasn't a regular base type of thing.
Yeah.
We lose, we're like, we're bringing somebody. we 2 wins in yarn and then that person's not there anymore. We lose a couple of games, we bring in somebody. So it was it was one of those situations, and it was always different. And for me, it was scary because it's something new.
Yeah,
I mean,
yeah.
I played for SuperSport, nothing like that happens.
Nothing
I
like
played
that.
For Rio Stars, there was nothing like that. I played for City Pillars, nothing was like that was happening. I was in the Bafana setup, nothing like that was happening.
Yeah.
And I was shocked, dude. If anybody has an image of me playing for Atlanta Pirates, they will realize my socks were always tapered here because I used to cut them because there was always stuff in it.
It was the Muti.
I don't know, Chief.
Yeah.
Wow, man. So I'll cut them and use my smaller socks underneath.
Yeah.
Right. And that's how I would play because socks are always wet. That's how I would play. And
so you can't say I don't want to use this Muti.
No. A lot of guys tried. They never survived.
They got benched.
it's either they never played regularly or they were not part of the team anymore.
Apart from the putting things in the socks, what else were they doing to you or expected you to do? Giving you things to wash with?
Yeah, we'll bath. No, seriously, we'll bath. You know, we'll bath.
It's in the book. They used to bath in, what's the black?
Yeah, I think it was something that was black in it. We'll bath just before the game, just before we go to the game, we'll bath. And the problem was, look, as long as something...
Oh, tell him the crazy story of... You used to bath and then go straight to the...
to the game. Because we'll bath, right? A night before.
Yeah.
And go back to our rooms, take a shower, sleep, we'll lose the game. And they're like, fuck. Clearly, these boys are not doing what you're supposed to do. So now,
Niwashi mood.
Yeah. So on the game day, after having a pre-match meal, as we're about to go to the bus, we need to pass that room, take a bath, get into the bus, go straight to the stadium. You there? You there in the ground? You're doing this. It's itchy. But it's I strongly believe I'm not sure, I highly doubt those are things that are still happening right now.
Yeah.
But at that time, many a team that we played against, they were doing stuff.
Yeah.
You'll see in the dressing room, there'll be smoke somewhere.
Man, Paul,
So a lot of teams were doing stuff. So for me, it as much as it was foreign to me, but it wasn't something that was not spoken about in the corridors. We knew certain teams were doing such things.